guys, it's Nerine and Pippin, who is too busy chewing on the straps to say hello.
Pippin, hi. Yeah? Hi.
But I am in the car today because I want to talk about 5 things that I have learned, tips and tricks with traveling with cats. Just as a note, we have been moving from Georgia to California, so it has been about a 3.5-day drive, and we only have 2 to 3 hours left before we get to Northern California. So this is all the stuff that we planned on and has kind of worked, the things that I would change, and all of that all wrapped up into one. So the drive is nearly over, so I would figure, you know, this is probably the end all be all with this decision.
Hi! You're not in the camera shot.
But I have my handy dandy little notebook and I have 5 things to tell you guys, and maybe Pippin will come back in frame. There she is. There she is. There's Pippin. So, first thing, which I'm sure you guys are all wondering about, with a cat in the car for, you know, 10 hours at a time, maybe 12 hours sometimes, where do they go to the bathroom? Because it's not like a dog. Admittedly, I've never traveled with a dog, but, you know, there's rest stops and you can get out and walk the dog and they can do their business there. But cats are a little bit different. She's right here. She's right here. Hi. Sorry. This is really weird in a car. Kind of awkward. I am recording. Good. All the things.
Hi.
So yeah, I've never traveled with a dog, but I assume that you can just, you know, get off at rest stops and let the dog do their business. But with cats, it's a different story because most cats are not outdoor cats. Pippin is an indoor-only cat, but we do occasionally walk her on a leash outside. We have not trained her at the moment to go in public areas outside. So, you know, strangers freak her out, cars freak her out. Kind of freak her out. She's more interested than anything, but I do still worry about her getting away from us. So we haven't let her outside the car except in her carrier, to and from the hotel and that kind of thing. So litter box. Oh, this ramble talking about the litter box without talking about the litter box. But we have a litter box inside the car, and that sounds kind of gross, and it kind of is, but Pippin's poop is on a bodily schedule, luckily enough. She poops in the morning, and we can usually catch it and be able to clean it within a couple of minutes. So she goes in the litter box, and we're able to stop and clean out the poop. And the litter box just holds the pee for the rest of the day. So we have a couple of litter pans in the US in grocery stores and places like that. They sell kind of single-use plastic litter pans already full with litter, which is very useful. We have a couple of them. The one that we use, I mean, it's not ideal. I wouldn't do it again, but yeah, they're useful for the car. What I would do instead, if I could do this over again, is to have just a normal litter pan, one of those plastic tubs, and have, sorry, Pippin's going on an adventure, and have just normal litter, because this litter for this particular brand is dusty. And both Pippin and Rujak are allergic to dust, and the dust has gotten all over the car. And it's working for our purposes. It's only, you know, 3.5 days in a car, and we can kind of live through that. But if I were to do this again, I would have just a normal plastic tub, you know, normal litter box tub with our own litter. But ideally the litter would be larger because it gets all over the car. Pippin tracks it everywhere. So it would be large kernels of litter and dust-free. So, moving on, we'll talk about food and water because, you know, 3.5 days, she's going to need to eat and drink. So what we do is we feed her at night, And this was before we left for the trip. And, you know, when we get to the hotel, we give her a can of food. And you can actually see the little cans right there. We give her a can of food at night, and she has all night to eat it and digest it and poop in the morning. And we also have water at the hotel. We have a cup of water out for her at all times. And in the car itself, when we're driving during the day, it's not the best to have a cup of water out for her all the time, just with the current setup of the car. So every time we stop at a rest area or things like that, we have a little, we have a cup, and we can fill it with a bottle of water every time we stop, and then put it back in the bottle and seal that up when we move. So she's kind of trained herself that when we stop, she gets water if she's thirsty. So that's what she knows. That she knows the drill by now. She's kind of rather trained. let's see. So, comfort and calm. This depends a whole lot on your cat's personality. My mom's cat would have a panic attack and probably kill herself if she had to spend 3.5 days in a car. But not kill herself intentionally, but, you know, she would have a heart attack because she is so terrified of driving. She drools and poops and pees on the way to the vet, and that's only like a 20-minute drive. So Pippin is much more easygoing than that. It all depends on the cat and usually what the cat experiences at a young age. We've had Pippin since she was about 8 months old, and she's been in the car fairly often. And she's used to kind of the drill. She's an easygoing cat, and she likes learning and new experiences, which is kind of weird to say for a cat. But yeah, she's a very easygoing cat, and she's gotten used to this drill. When the car is moving, she is on this console asleep, which is great. So another thing is that she does somewhat panic. She doesn't really like the close confines of the car. It's kind of unfamiliar, less unfamiliar now because she spent so much time in it recently, but she works herself up. She starts panting and open mouth breathing. This was one particular experience that we had, but as long as we have a cool air vent pointed towards her, so we have vents here and in the center console, as long as they're pointed towards her, towards the back, she is happy. As long as it's cool air and it can cool her down and all of that, she is quite happy. Let's see. Yeah, so that's about it for keeping her calm, and we're getting a weird sun ray. I apologize. It's kind of an impromptu car vlog at the rest stop when we could. So that's, I guess, it for comfort and calm. Hi! You're not where you're supposed to be. So speaking of her not being where she's meant to be, we're going to talk about car boundaries. So if you didn't know, if you couldn't gather from the rest of this video, Pippin rides outside of her carrier in the car. So we have our carrier back here. I can show you in a little clip to the side. We bring her in the carrier to and from the hotel or any buildings that we bring her inside, and then we let her out in the car. So that means that she can roam free. However, for safety, she is not allowed in the driver's area. So anywhere around the seat or the footwell where she is now, which is not a very good thing, but I'm kind of distracted at the moment. And generally it's okay when there's no one in the seat. But as long as someone is in the seat, she is not allowed in the driver's zone. In the seat, on the person's lap, in by the pedals, down below, or anywhere up on the dashboard. And she listens to that pretty well. And it works pretty well. So another thing is, for boundaries, there's no other real boundaries around, and we are getting a weird rainbow. Hopefully that'll fix the rainbow. I'm sorry. This is kind of a weird setup, but, other than that, for boundaries, she doesn't really have any. She's allowed anywhere else inside the cabin. So I guess another thing about boundaries is she has all her claws. She did not have her front claws removed. So she likes to scratch. And you know, when the cat is somewhere for 12 hours at a time, they want to scratch. So she scratches the upholstery. We try to keep her from doing it, and she knows that she's not supposed to, but it doesn't prevent her from doing so. It just reduces the amount that she scratches. There's not too much damage to these seats, which is pretty nice. She's been pretty good about it. So number five, the last thing is hotels. Because we're kind of taking it easy on this drive. We're not driving through the night. We're not doing anything insane. This 3.5 days includes, you know, 3 nights staying in places. So we stay in hotels, and we in particular stay in hotels that allow pets. I want to be honest and, you know, honor the fact that we do have a cat that we are taking into a hotel. Some people are allergic to cats, and, you know, Pippin could in theory destroy a hotel room. So some of the hotels that I found work are La Quinta. La Quinta is a hotel chain, at least in the U.S., I'm not quite sure where else, but they allow pets to stay in most of their locations for free. There's no additional charge whatsoever. Another hotel is Best Western. A lot of their properties allow pets. There is a pet deposit, which can be up to $20. Last night we paid $15 extra to have Pippin, but you know, I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do, and I'd rather us all be comfortable and all of that. So another note about the hotel is that we also stayed in the hotel so that she's not in a car 24 hours at a time. It gives her space to run around. She can stay up all night and sleep during the car all day. So that's pretty much it. If you see anything in particular, any brands in this video, like the two hotels that I mentioned or anything like that, we are not endorsed or sponsored or anything. This is just my experiences and all of that. And yeah, so sorry Pippin has not been in the video like I planned. She is sleeping. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time for the Pippin will see you next time. Goodbye.
Hi, sweet girl. Are you having fun in the car? Are you having a fun time? Are you having a fun time? Yeah. Good baby. Good girl.
And it's kind of cramped because we are moving, so we have all of our stuff. We have a rooftop bag up at the top. We have bikes in the back. And our computers are here, and you know, this whole back seat is a little cramped for space, but we left some space for her. She likes to sit here and on the center console. Here is her carrier, which we use to carry her in between buildings in the car. And here's her litter box, her nice dirty litter box, which actually needs to be a little bit better. So this is one of those kind of single use trays. I don't know if you can see, but there was a dust plume when I moved the litter. But it's nice large chunks, which is easy to clean up. Oh, another thing that I would recommend if you are taking a cat on a car in a car ride with a litter box is to bring one of those little hand vacuums to clean up. We don't have one yet, but we need to get one. But yeah. Alright, thank you guys for watching, and we will see you next time. Goodbye!